Okay, well, we're at the point with our Project Schofield, the XJ, that we're going to modify, finally to the good stuff. You know, we've walked you through what it takes to pick out a good XJ, cleaning it up, getting it ready. We brought it down to Phil's Auto House, to my good friend Phil Sanchez's shop, to kind of get it tuned up, to kind of see what we were looking at as far as the mechanical condition of the XJ. But now it's really time for the fun stuff. Because what we're going to do here is put on our SkyJacker lift, the Goodyear 31-inch tall tires. The lift is a 3.5, plus some Durango bumpers, a few other things like our Ramsey winch. Now, one of the points I want to make is, again, a lot of times people will get ready to project a vehicle, and first thing they'll do is go buy a lift kit. Then they're going to try to find tires to match it. And then they're going to try to change their gear ratios or find their speedometers off. Or, you know, it's a mix and match project. What you got to do is first sit down and think about what you're going to do with your Jeep or whatever off-road vehicle that you're getting ready to modify. In our case, what happened with Schofield here is we wanted to keep it within a really good budget, but we wanted it to be really reliable, but we're not really setting it up for super serious off-roading. I knew I didn't want to go too high, didn't want to put too big of tires on it, and what happened is when we called SkyJacker to find out about our lift, I said I didn't want too tall. What's the lowest lift I can get and still put on, say, 31s or 33s? Finally decided 31s because we could go with a 3.5-inch lift kit. Then I really thought we'd go with the Super Trick Double Flex. Well, you know what? Not only is a Double Flex lift more expensive, but you give up some of the highway capability for increased off-road capability, and that was something that we decided, because of who's going to be driving it, where it's going to be driven, that that's not something that we were willing to do. So we've got all our stuff out here. Again, we decided on the SkyJacker 3.5-inch lift kit should probably give us about 3 inches of lift, just enough to clear our MTRs in 31 inches. Then, once we get that lift kit on, we're going to bolt on our Durango 4x4 bumpers, front and rear, with a swing-away spare tire carrier, put our Ramsey winch on the front, and then we're going to be ready to try it out. Now, of course, before we pull it out of the shop, we're also going to probably finish up those mechanical details that we had, like the loose tail shaft. So we're going to have to put a new bearing in there, I believe. Rear brakes, adjust the emergency brake, those kind of things. So what we're going to do is we've got Phil and the gang. I think I could call them gang because I think they've served their time. Maybe I should call them crew, that are ready here so we can put this together in the next couple segments. So let's get started. Now that's one of those things we should have thought about, because the bushings there where that shackle is.
You're gonna have
we got new bushings
for the lift
for the for the spring, but not for the shackle mounting to the frame. SkyJacker on those brake lines, they said the stock ones would work.
Stock ones work, okay.
Yeah. So I was kind of, I was shocked when I thought, okay, they should know because they knew the tire size and stuff.
I got it.
Yep. Well, I've got a lot of stock springs laying around. Okay, so that's all we got to do then about the brake lines, because we're not worried about the brake line, we're worried about the emergency brake lines.
Yeah.
Okay, so then all we got to do is disconnect those, and then what, we'll just kind of stretch those
springs?
Yeah,
we'll relocate them after we find where they naturally lay, and then we can set
just keep
them up.
That. All we're going to have to do is worry about keeping it off the muffler, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Well, there's a problem we don't have then. What have you thought about? what was this about torque? Well, why is that in critical?
Well, yeah, what you want to do is when you're installing a lift kit or any item, you want to make sure that if you're going to use the existing hardware, that you don't want to go past its original design. So you want to make sure that you have the torque specs, you want to torque it down to your original specifications. That way we know everything is going to work the way it did. And then inspect the hardware to make sure that we don't have a wear problem, you know?
Okay.
But other than that, that's one thing you really
especially
want to concentrate on.
If you're putting new stuff to old stuff.
Exactly, exactly, yeah. You know, lubricate things, just mm-hmm. take that extra time because this is going to be, this is, when what, 170,000 miles?
Yeah, yeah.
So we'd like to go another 170, you know?
That would
so we
be
want
nice.
To make sure, yeah, so we want to make okay. sure it's all adjusted right.
Well, cool, one more thing we learned then. Okay, we finished putting the lift on the rear of the XJ. Fairly simple, fairly straightforward. A couple of things we found was, you know, check the condition of the bushings on the top of the shackles. Those bushings, if they're really bad, to replace them, come as a whole part of that whole shackle assembly. And, you know, the dealer, it's, say, $30, $40 item. So check the condition while you're here. It'd be good to replace them unless they're in great shape. The other thing we found is that when you put this lift on, you've got to be pretty careful with the brake lines. All we did was make a little extension to bring this up, but it's got to be mounted solid for the brakes to work. But you got to check the clearance on this. The e-brake lines are okay. We just pulled those springs a little bit so it holds it up. We got to keep it away from the muffler. So, pretty uneventful. Amazingly enough, we probably spent as much time trying to get the bushings and the hardware on the shock ends as we did putting the springs on. Now, we have mounted these shocks 180 degrees. I'm not going to say upside down from what the stock shocks were. All my older off-road racing days, we always mounted the shaft down, the body up. I've talked to a couple shock people and they say it really doesn't make any difference which way the shock is on these type of shocks. So, that went without a hitch. While we're back here, what we're going to do now is go ahead and switch and put the rear bumper on and that hardware. And that should be, hopefully, a piece of cake. We'll find out.